Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the complainer of all complainers, the fault finder of every star in the sky, the grumbler of every opportunity, the protester of all protesters, the most oppressed man in America, the marshmallow of grande proportions, the one, the only, Colin. The only reason I'm making this video is because he ruined my July 4th groove. This never would have happened, Colin Kaepernick, if you wouldn't have gone and put your foot in it again. I was blissfully unaware until I peeled my eyes on this. Arizona Governor Doug Ducey ripped Nike on Tuesday for its decision to cancel the release of a shoe featuring an early design of the U.S. flag, commonly known as the Betsy Ross flag, which is appropriate because it's July 4th, America's Independence Day. But, according to a report from the Wall Street Journal on Monday, Nike decided to recall the shoe from retailers after former NFL quarterback, hint hint, former, Colin Kaepernick contacted the company and told them that he and others find the symbol offensive. The Betsy Ross flag has been appropriated by some extremist groups as a symbol of white nationalism. Dude, when is this going to end? You know, I can pick anything out in this world and say it is a symbol of white nationalism. My purse can be a symbol of white nationalism. My nail polish can be a symbol of white nationalism. In fact, without anyone even knowing what I look like, my own voice can be a symbol of white nationalism. Anything can be a symbol of white nationalism if it's made to be so. Nike has chosen not to release the Air Max 1 Quick Strike 4th of July as it featured the old version of the American flag, the company said in a statement provided to USA Today Sports. And of course, we don't want to hurt Colin Kaepernick's feelings, so the entire US must comply. Colin Kaepernick reached out to Nike saying that he and others felt the Betsy Ross flag is an offensive symbol because of its connection to an era of slavery. I cannot even express in so many words how stupid that sounds. I can connect a million things we have today in the US that can be in connection to an era of slavery. Any invention, any item that we have today that has seen progress from that time till today can be in connection to that era of slavery. Anything. In fact, why doesn't Colin Kaepernick protest phones? Because it was in connection to an era of Jim Crow. And let's include fax machines too. In fact, let's also add computers. Let's all just go live in caves and burn everything we have, because it's all in connection with some bad things in history. But before we get extreme, let's learn some things. In the summer of 1776, Betsy Ross, newly widowed, is said to have received a visit from George Washington for a new flag design. It was said that Washington and the Continental Congress had come up with the basic layout, but Betsy Ross finished the design. This is the breakdown of the progress of our flag throughout the years. It never had anything to do with slavery. It had to do with this country breaking from rule of Britain and becoming a nation on its own and progressing to the future superpower of the world. In fact, historically, the greatest power in the world. Now, Colin was born in 87 and was adopted by none other than white parents. I could only wonder what he substituted his thank yous to them with. Let's read on. Football was his number one love. He penned a letter predicting that he would be a starting quarterback. He said, "I hope I go to a good college in football, then go to the pros and play on the Niners or the Packers, even if they aren't good in 7 years. Look at these words. I hope I go to a good college. So why would someone who is extremely oppressed hold out so much hope for an opportunity in the country that oppresses people and by oppressing people takes away their opportunities? And the other part is that he hopes to go to a good college. At the time, it didn't seem this country was too oppressive to give him a chance to go to college and make his hopes come true. It's only oppressive now that he got in and eventually out." So with the issue of standing up for the national anthem, "I am not going to stand up to show pride in a flag for a country that oppresses black people and people of color. To me, this is a bigger than football, and it would be selfish on my part to look the other way." So it's selfish on his part, but it was generous on the part of the college, his parents, and everyone who backed him up into getting into football and making his hope come true. So he filed a grievance against NFL owners for collusion. Because how dare they not hire him and oppress him after he practically told the world how much he dislikes America, the country where he has everything. And GQ further rewarded him as Citizen of the Year. How can someone who is unpatriotic and dislike this country be a good citizen? Question for thought. It just goes to show how delusional these people are in their view of oppression. They don't know what true oppression is until they really have been oppressed. His net worth is about $20 million. So I'm truly not understanding, what part is he ungrateful for? That his hope came true? That he has a good place to live with running water, probably a nice bathroom, food every day, a car that works on roads that are paved, and gets paid a lot of money? What he and everyone else like him failed to see, as usual, was that this country was not only built by white people, but by non-whites as well. Their contributions matter in history, and by saying such stupid things that he does, he discredits their hard work and their sacrifices too. It was hard for black people to get into the army or the military, but fast forwarding to the moment where they did, segregation of troops was not the norm, and this is talking in terms of the American Revolution, our independence. Blacks fought, drilled, marched, ate, and slept alongside their white counterparts. There was never enough food or clothes or even pay for anyone, but they shared their hardships equally. Military historian Major Glenn Williams has said, "I've heard one analysis say that the army during the Revolutionary War was the most integrated that the army would be until the Korean War, World War I and World War II both, and of course the Civil War. There were lots of blacks in uniform, but the men were segregated into separate units in those wars. The Revolutionary War was seen not only as independence for America, but there were a lot of black people who saw it as independence for themselves and for their future kids, grandkids, great-grandkids, and so on. So they made an effort too. They fought in that war, Colin Kaepernick. Where is your thank you to them?" After watching a review of the Continental Army in New York, one French officer estimated that as much as a quarter of the army was black. He may have been looking at the first Rhode Island or units from Connecticut and New Jersey, which also had high rates of black enlistment. Though the records have been destroyed, Williams said most historians believe that 10 to 15% is a more accurate representation of black soldiers who served in the Revolution. They served in almost every unit, in every battle from Concord to Fort Ticonderoga to Trenton to Yorktown. This one's for you, Colin Kaepernick. You who knows nothing. You discredit the bravery and the sacrifices of these soldiers who died, who got wounded. Most of these were probably teenagers. Let's keep reading. "Their service and heroism is invaluable. It came at a time when the new United States needed it very badly, and they stepped up and they took their place in the ranks. If they were misrepresented in our histories before, then we owe it to them to make sure we include it now." Let me repeat. We owe it to them to make sure we include it now, on 4th of July, that we celebrate every year, because they certainly did their part to earn not only their own freedom, but ours as well. We should never forget that for them. It was a double fight for liberty, their own and their country's. What a brave act on the part of these African soldiers. The 4th of July is for them too. That flag that Nike decided to listen to Colin on and take away, that flag was for those Africans, those soldiers, and every soldier that fought and died so that we can have our independence. And Kaepernick has the audacity to blast them out of history. What an embarrassment. So this 4th of July, celebrate with your families and remember every single person that fought so that you can have your freedom today. Don't listen to someone like Kaepernick. He doesn't know his history, and he doesn't care about the blood that was shed for him to be able to go to college and follow his hope. It's truly insulting. Now that is a real offense. Let's check out some facts about the war. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel and check out my other videos. Make sure your notification bell is turned on so you can get updates for new videos and answers to your comments.
Educate yourself!